It is time for the conference tournament as we wind down the 2020 season here at ETSU. And just a real quick look at the results, how things have gone since that last match that you guys watched. So obviously, we finished with the perfect record. We had a couple tight matches. Northeastern, I had to win that one late with an 89th minute goal. I started my second team in that match, and they sort of played like it, gave up a goal almost immediately. And so we spent a lot of the game trying to dig out of holes that we dug. Then we played Mercer, and Mercer had tied it almost immediately after we scored the first goal of the match. But we were able to get a winner in the 63rd on a penalty. Alberto Padone scored both of those. And so now here we stand. We are 16-0-0, which sounds good. But as I said all along, our schedule is not the most difficult. Our conference season was actually a little more challenging than our non-conference, as we sort of tore through the non-conference and then had a few close calls in the conference. So you could chalk it up to an easy schedule, I guess. We did have some good games, some good performances, but you can't put too much into that 16-0-0 record. Although, hey, we beat all the teams that were in front of us, so you do what you got to do. And looking real quick at our squad, at our how well our squad has done, looking at the statistics, starting first of all, I told you Jones and Padone were a little disappointing in their production. They have picked it up, as you can see, in the last five games. Padone is 7.04, Jones a 7. Padone has 5 goals, 2 assists, Jones 2 goals, 2 assists. So my front three, not as productive as I would like. They're still scoring goals and creating chances. Joe Dixon, the number 10 player from central midfield, is doing the same. Even Goez getting involved. So you see what it is. We're spreading the wealth, right? If any one striker had, 11, 16 goals. If you split 16 goals between two players, you'd be really excited. Well, we've just spread those out between, 5 players. So we'll take that. Also, I would look at Florian Walker has 5 assists, so he's been a big part of our scoring production. And then Andrew Webb has knocked in 3 goals off of corner kicks, set pieces. So production from the first 11 has been pretty good. Even backups have gotten involved, as we saw, although not as much as they were early in the season. Aaron Evans has 3 goals and an assist. And Grijalva, who I don't think has scored in a while, but he had 2 goals. Rodriguez, he takes my penalties when he's in the game. He's got 3 goals. Attacking wise, it's been pretty good. Defensively, Webb has actually been a little bit of a disappointment. He's only winning 73% of his tackles, and he's made 10 mistakes. That's not great. Gordon, though, has 17 tackles, and he has a 100% tackle percentage. So Gordon's been good. Webb still has some work to do to be a kind of a lockdown defender that we would like for him to be. But can't argue with 16-0, right? Looking at our opponent, though, well, first let's just look at how the Southern Conference tournament has gone. We'll go all the way back to the wild card. So Furman finished 6th in the regular season. So we look at the seedings. We've obviously finished on top. Belmont, out of nowhere, finished 2nd. VMI, 3rd. And then Greensboro, 4th. Mercer, 5th. And then 2 of the better programs, Wofford and Furman, down near the bottom, 6th and 7th. So they would play in the wild card round. Furman won on penalties, which meant they had to go to overtime. And in the next match, they would lose to VMI 3-1. No doubt they were fatigued, which is part of the reason for the setup of that tournament, is to give the teams that had a better regular season, let them be a little more fresh. So VMI, UNC Greensboro won, and that puts us where we are now. VMI absolutely ran Belmont off the field, so I guess they're riding some momentum there. We hopefully can go to the final to play them, and I guess we'll see right now if we can do that. Oh, do we have a penalty? We do. Here's Padone. Goal. Sixth goal of the season for Padone. A lot of nothing in this match. But hey, 71%. We definitely dominated the latter part of that half. And we got a penalty goal to show for it. Back to Santangelo to Gordon. Get rid of it. I've had a couple of really dumb giveaway goals in the back. Jones to Swinehart. Padone's shot goes over. I really want to finish one of these chances. So the final is going to be in 2 days. I really want to try and keep everybody as fresh as I can, which means as soon as players get below 80, I'm going to start subbing them. Swinehart out wide. Padone! I would really have liked for you to finish that. Although this could be it here. And it is. All right. So, kind of a boring match, but 1-0 win moves us on. Survive in advance, and we did that. So it's a good win for us. We now go to the final. We've taken on VMI, a team who, as I recall, we'll look at it here in a second, but we beat them pretty easily during the regular season. And I hope, able to get most of my guys starting 11 off the field quick enough so that they'll be mostly rested for that. Whereas VMI probably played their first team for most of the match. Yeah, see, we beat them 4-1. We had a 4-0 lead. They scored to the 55th, but we pretty much dominated. Let's see if we can still. Yeah, 25-11, 70% possession. So that say, let's watch their goal. How did they score? This might have been the goal that was really stupid where my defender sat on it for too long. Oh, no, it was just on a counter. Okay. Oh, yeah, that was some kind of horse hockey going on down there. Yeah, so VMI should be a team that we should be able to beat and win our second straight conference tournament. So we made it to the final. We are now 17-0-0 VMI. They were, what were they, fourth? Third in the regular season. In there, let's look at their non-conference setup. Yeah, they were down near the bottom. So that's a game we should feel confident about, but, you know, things happen. If you don't score goals, you don't win matches. So hopefully we can score some goals in the final. And we'll be back to see the final in just a moment. And here we go. Southern Conference Tournament Final. This is for an automatic bid to the NCAA Tournament, although I feel like I've done well enough to get into the NCAA Tournament even without winning this match. But we always want to add to the trophy case, so let's real quick look at VMI. So VMI, they're not quite as fit as we are. As I kind of anticipated, they did not sub the way we did during the semifinal, so their players are mostly in the mid-80s. And whereas I am pretty close to fully fit. Not only did I sub, but I also rested my guys for that day in between just because this game is on a Sunday and I did have stuff for training on a Saturday. So I went ahead and let the starting 11 rest, recuperate. And so they're mostly ready to go, whereas VMI is not. So hopefully that'll be an advantage, have a little fitness advantage. And I also feel like my players are just better. And I have more depth, meaning I could put my second 11 in and feel like I could possibly win the match. Just to start today, I am going to start in my 4-3-3, kind of whatever, standard. And maybe if I'm having trouble creating, go ahead and put in the 4-3-3 with the wingbacks. I just feel like for tournament play, I'm going to need to be a little more... take a slightly more defensive posture. And so figure might as well go ahead and do that now. And what I am going to do though, just for this match, I'm going to start out balanced just because I, you know, get a read on the game, figure out what I need to change. And when I do that, I usually let the guys be a little more expressive just so that they'll be a little more creative in the attack because we'll have fewer guys getting, you know, lower tempo, all that stuff. So with all that said, let's see how things go. VMI, the Virginia Military Institute, they are a little bit of a surprise package here in the later part of the season. They think they finish as the third seed in our conference. Did not have that great of a non-conference results. And we're already, we got a free kick there. So things are going pretty well for us so far. We'll go ahead and tell the guys to get creative. I don't remember where I got this, but get creative is one of the shouts I use a lot. I'm just trying to get the guys to be a little more aggressive in the attack. And does it work? I don't know. I don't know that anybody can prove that shouts work. I mean, you'll give the shout, and then you'll get a reaction from the guys, either red or green, who knows what effect it really has. But it's in the game, so, you know, I'm sure we all do it. And goes there, wins that free ball. Swinehart, now he has it back. Walter back to Gordon, up to Swinehart. Goez now waiting for a little pressure, inviting pressure, finally gets it. Here we go. Oh, that's going to be a goal. Nice. Kind of well worked there. I feel like there was a mistake. It looked like there was a mistake there by one of the VMI defenders. Let's see. Walter has it. He's playing two touch. Oh, Justin, nice. Yeah, the defender did put a bad touch on the ball, but Padone was there and pounced. It was a nice through ball. It was a good thought. And luckily, VMI made a mistake that made it an even better decision. Made the decision better than the execution actually was. So here's Zhang Yiwen with the cross. Nope, he lays it back for Goez. A shot is wide. This is intense. This is a championship game. And you know, in effect, it's a cup final. Goez drops it back to Walter. It's a Dixon. To Jones. Oh, Padone puts a move on the defender. Gets shot, but does not. It's right in the keeper's hand. So I'm going to tell the guys again to get creative. Let's get another goal. Yeah, see, it's mostly good. Gordon was feeling a little pressured, but I mean, it's got to have some impact, right? Why else would they have it in the game? VMI heads the ball over there on that set piece. Dixon now drops it to Walter. Finds Iron out in the back or on the left wing. Now we're back into the middle zone here. Swinehart with a shot. Crabtree, the keeper, tips it over. So at the half-hour mark, we have a set-piece corner. And, oh, Padone got his hand on it. Okay. My assistant tells me they're a little more attacking, but I feel like I'm okay. Okay, now, see, now that's kind of irritates me. And with my teams that I kind of coach in real life, when we get kind of pinned into one side, rotate it, get the ball to the other side where there's fewer players, we can get another attack. Ewan drops it to Walter. Here's Jones. Oh, through ball to Dixon. Oh, I needed a better touch on that. There was just nothing on that. Jones gets a yellow. I'll wait till the half. Okay, first half, possession not great. I'd like for that to be better, but we do have eight shots on target to their two, or I'm sorry, eight shots to their two, five on target to their one. Mostly playing well. Goal kick, oh, Swinehart wins it. And drops it to Walter, to Goez, back to Walter, to Dixon. See, this is where I feel like, oh, Padone, nice through ball. That ball was destined for the goal line. And the VMI defender makes a last-ditch effort to save it. And here comes Hare. Okay, good. Stop that counter. Dead in its tracks. Thinking about, let's go ahead and start bringing in some subs since we're picking up yellows here. Bring in Evans for Jones. Going to let Barron, who is not fully fit, but he needs to get fit. Let's tell him to not ease off tackles. Oh, I missed it. Well, Padone scores the second goal. Hopefully the match killer. Walter here in a little trouble to Dixon to Goez. There's a nice ball back to Dixon in space. Padone just beats the defenders. Kind of splits two. Puts a nice little finish, nothing fancy. Low to the far post, and I do like to praise them every once in a while after we get a goal or get a two. Oh, now we have a penalty, and Padone with his second. Oh, sorry, it's his hat trick. So three goals again. VMI, I was never really overly worried about this game, and probably with good reason. Gone to a 4-3-3 narrow attack, and of course they get a goal immediately before I have time to change my tactics. Okay, shut up shop, and we'll just go defensive. And meanwhile, give the shout for the guys. Maybe you guys can tell me what y'all do. In this situation, I'm up by multiple goals. I've tried concentrate, I get mixed results. Demand more usually just does better for me. Demand more is one that I usually give when my defense is playing poorly. Oh, there's the C. Oh. Okay, that's 3-2. Now it's a little nervous times because they're probably gonna have another minute of stoppage. We're probably going to have to hold them for another minute. No, I guess that's it. Yeah, we won the cup, but I really did not like how that game ended. Giving up two goals. It's like we were trying to get into the overtime. I need to work on my shut up shop strategy, I guess. So, all right. We obviously, big win for the program. 13 shots to their 6. Again, 58% possession, that irritates me. Did not like giving up two goals at the end, but you know, I'm going to try to bright side it, right? We'll pretend the last 10 minutes didn't happen. Real quick look back at the match stats. Passing, yeah, 88%. Yeah, passing out of defense was bad. It's usually lower, but that was poor, so probably need to rethink some of what I'm doing back there with the guys that I have back there. All right. Yeah, two goals in stoppage time. Oh, my goodness. Like, that's irritating. When they score two goals a minute apart, it's like my guys just gave up, nailed their feet to the grass, and, well, that's frustrating. But, hey, conference champion second year in a row, conference tournament champion second year in a row. We'll take it. We're off to the NCAA tournament. This episode probably went a little longer than they usually do, but we did two live comms, and I did try to, you know, mash those down to cut out some of the time. But long story short, we, despite VMI's best late efforts, we won the conference tournament, so we will get the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. So our next episode will be an NCAA tournament episode. Hopefully we go deep into the tournament. If we do, I might cut that episode into two or three parts. But clearly we are getting closer to where we want to be, although we're not there yet talent-wise. We still have to develop some players to get to the upper echelon of the NCAA. But, you know, you take the NCAA tournament one match at a time, who knows what happens. So this is Uncle Sam. I'm going to sign off. I'll see you next time.